Carol, where's my shirt? Where's my shirt?
I am getting your shirt in just a minute.
Well, you're not going to get it standing there. Come on.
Боже мой, что ты меня так сразу злишь? Какая муха тебя сегодня укусила?
Mike?
Pages from a magazine, been looking for the answers ever since we were 17. You know the truth can be a weapon to fight this world of ill intentions. A new answer to the same question: how many times will you learn the same lesson?
This week's headlines: it's getting hot in here, so take off all your clothes. And good evening and welcome to CNT News. My name is Kami Sutra and today is Tuesday, the 20th of February. In a week where reports suggest that a man claiming to be a time traveller has passed a polygraph test. His warnings of AI taking over the world and impending doom appear to be overshadowed by the revelations that Donald Trump will indeed win a second term in office. A week where Boston Dynamics unveil a robot that can open doors and even enter your home unassisted. Skynet is upon us. But nobody cares about that. Donald Trump is apparently going to get a second term in office. A week where Apple employees discover the difficulties in installing Windows. And a week where wannabe influencers across Snapchat give excuse after excuse for ignoring their audience to focus on their egos. In a week like this, you need a news source that you can rely on. A news source that puts you at the centre of the story. And we at CNT, together with you, we really do aim to make fake news great again. Sometimes in life, all you need is a hug or someone to tell you that everything's going to be okay, or rough sex or whatever, which may explain in part why Australia had the hashtag bonk ban trending worldwide last week, after the Prime Minister of the country banned ministers from having sex with their staff. And for once, it is not our Barnaby that has been caught with his pants at his ankles. No, Australian Minister Barnaby Joyce, who... Australian Minister Barnaby Joyce, who makes me look like a safe pair of hands. Now, when it comes to reporting in a story like this, it's Australia. Let's hear from Sharon Breakers.
That's right, Cammy. I'm here at Parliament House in Canberra, where the Australian Prime Minister, Malcolm Turnbull, recently called on for a press conference. Now, CNT was first on the ground here to get the story for our viewers. Now, although this is a recording behind me, I can reveal that at the press conference, he did say to the public that as of today, all ministers are banned from having sexual relations with their staff. It's otherwise known as the bonk ban. CNT approached the Prime Minister for comment, but he was on his way out to catch a flight to the US for his upcoming visit with US President Donald Trump, no doubt to get some more advice on what Australia should do in this situation. I can also report, Cammy, that CNT approached other politicians to get their feedback on this recent ban, and unfortunately, they all scrambled away after the press conference, no doubt to attend to the last-minute bonking, ministerial business. Sharon Brake News here. Nothing to report, CNT News. So, Mike, are we done? Good-o. Bloody hell, I think it's a great idea. I mean, can you imagine these blokes on me? Oh, shit, I can't think of anything worse. They've got faces like smashed crabs. Oh, shit. Ooh. You what? What did you say? Bloody hell. Come here. Come here!
Shazza, thank you. Sharon Brake News reporting there. Bonking ban. I mean, what next? Barnaby Joyce for Minister of Families. Anyway, enough of that, Barnaby. Time to catch up with our Barnaby, who, fresh from last week's exploits in North Korea, has decided to jump from the frying pan into the fire, as we have a report that takes a look at the Ring of Fire. No, not the Ring of Fire that Johnny Cash kept falling into. No, the Ring of Fire is an area of the planet where we see increased levels of seismic activity. In the past few weeks, we've seen a lot of action in the Ring of Fire, with Japan, Taiwan, and even Mexico feeling tremors. Many scientists worry that we are due a big volcanic eruption. Which is why we're sending Barnaby Freckleton.
Yes, thank you, Camperton. I'm Barnaby Freckleton, live here from the Pacific Ring of Fire. Mexico City, sadly, hit with a 7.2 magnum earthquake. What'd I say? Magnum. Yeah, magnum. Magnitude. Oh, okay. Well, they'll get it. This is just one of a cluster of rapidly occurring earthquakes on the Pacific Ring of Fire that has the world concerned that the big one is near. Those of us living along the Pacific Ring of Fire have been expecting the big dong for years now. We've been warned for my entire lifetime that the big one is coming. This has been a gold mine for insurance companies who are trying to sell you earthquake insurance. Here on the Pacific Ring of Fire, it has really become the big fraud, not the big one. Oh, be careful. You might lose everything in a giant earthquake. You should spend $22,000 a year on earthquake insurance. Naturally, Cammy, this fraud has been perpetrated by the same group of scientists who have brought us climate change.
Some people mistakenly think that they have earthquake coverage with their homeowner's policy, and they do not.
Hey, why don't you just do something stupid like hide under a doorway or, ooh, seek cover. Nothing's going to fall on me. Earthquake clusters, climate change, the sky not being blue, there's evidence of none of it. I'm Barnaby Freckleton, CNT News.
Barnaby, thank you. Young Barnaby reporting for us there, showcasing his knowledge of all things ring-shaped. And now we turn our attention to Donald Trump's 2019 budget proposal. Yes, what is Donald Trump going to cut in order to pay for more bombs? Let's see here. Environmental Protection Agency, down 33.7%. National Science Foundation, down 29.5%. State Department, down 26.9%. The Labour Department, down 21.4%. Medicare, down 7.1%. And Medicaid, down a whopping 22.5%, thanks to the repeal and replacement of Obamacare. And after a year of catastrophic weather, we're going to see cuts to the National Weather Service by a whopping $75 million, which may well see 248 weather forecasters lose their jobs. I think we all know who we're going to turn to for this one. Wendy.
Thank you, Cammy. That's right. Big developments in my industry this week as Donald Trump seeks to let go of 248 people from the National Weather Service. Now, is this his ongoing disdain for the weather, or does it have anything to do with the recent developments in the Stormy Daniels case? Which I might add is a fantastic name that I wish I had thought of. We all know that weather is a thankless job and that we take a lot of abuse for the bad predictions that we often make. But when I learned that the highest salaries were between $60,000 and $100,000, I felt bad for these people. Of course I feel bad that they could possibly lose their jobs. But then the fear set in. What if they flood to Snapchat, where I am the number one weather influencer and where my views matter?
Now, of course, the world is still grappling with Trump withdrawing from the Paris Accord, and we wanted to address it one more time before we say goodnight. To help us understand climate change and what it means to the world, here's our own Jim Jeffrey Show weatherman. How's it looking out there, weatherman?
Thank you, Jim. So things are going to be getting warmer in this area here and this area here.
Thank you, Jim Jeffrey Show weatherman. Do you have any future forecasts for us?
There is no future.
Wonderful. That's our show. I'm Jim Jeffries. I think we can all do better. Good night, everyone.
Why do views matter? Because we don't get paid here at CNT, and Snapchat is my only source of income. But come to think of it, maybe Donald Trump has done me a favor. Maybe I can now teach all of those people how to be Snapchat weather influencers. Meteorologist Wendy Applebottom, back to you, Cammy.
Wendy, thank you. Snapchat weather influencer and meteorologist to the stars, Wendy Applebottom reporting there. Now, as I curse my lucky stars at not having a beer this week and go console myself in the corner, we'll be back after these with the news.
In Pyeongchang.
Liz Sweeney dropping in, trying to get into this right wall for a nice, just getting up to the top of the wall, going for these grabs, the safety grab you'll see there, and then opting for another, just cruising up to the top.
Most Californians live within 30 miles of an active fault, and now more Californians are protecting their homes with insurance from the California Earthquake Authority. Announcing a seismic shift. Earthquake insurance that offers more coverage choices, more deductible options, and more affordable rates. With flexible policies to fit your needs and budget, get the strength to rebuild, repair, and recover.
Every Tuesday. I need beer for the news. Because the news is shite without the... And we're back. And it's just about time for us to head over to Arizona. Yes, Arizona. A desert that people choose to live in. And being from Glasgow, it's a world away. A world away. I can only imagine the heat that people must have to endure there. And it's no wonder they invest in swimming pools. On a very hot day, I can imagine the relief one receives from diving into a nice cool pool. However, as is the case in life, not everything can go to plan. And with this story reporting on some murky waters, let's cross to Crystal Waters.
Thank you, Cammy. This is Crystal Waters with a scoop on the poop.
Do you see this? Wait, what's
going on? I'm
standing in the bathroom where the fecal matter was not found at the recent event. Some say it was an accident, some say it was on poopus.
It's already in there.
Where?
They're like looking at it. It's already in the pool on the steps. People. Oh, this
he
is gonna
did,
be epic. Film it, film it, what are you doing?
My car just got
me. Oh no, film it, film it with yours.
As you can see, Cammy, everyone has evacuated.
I'll start with the cover.
Literally.
Crystal, thank you. Crystal Waters reporting there. Some good shit. Yes. Now, for our next story, we're going to take a look at stocks. And not the kind of medieval torture variety, the financial torture variety. In 2018, it is safe to say that to build a successful business is extremely difficult. We all can't be in the fortunate position of all-round moron Elon Musk to receive $2 billion payouts from the American government just to keep our company afloat. No, we have to invest our money wisely. And is this possible on the stock market? Yes, the stock market. And we need look no further than our beloved Snapchat to see the uncertainty attached to investing in shares in a company. Yes, stock prices go up and down, more than Stormy Daniels. Is there a safe investment? Could we possibly buy stocks in stocks? Let's pass to Trent Stone.
Thanks, Cammy. It's been a rough year for investors in Wall Street. We began the year with stocks trading at an all-time high, only to be followed by the largest drop in Wall Street history. This leaves many investors wondering where money can stay safe in such a volatile market. The answer, guns. That's right, gun stocks always perform well, especially after mass shootings. We're just 50 days into 2018, and already there have been 30 mass shootings. And as every sane person would expect, when there's a mass shooting, gun stocks go up.
Trent, this is sickening. How can investors live with themselves?
Well, three reasons, actually. Wall Street likes a winner, and gun stocks have historically delivered a body count, taking out competitors such as Facebook, Google, and Apple. Number two, Americans are actually buying more guns. There are more guns in America than there are people. The average gun owner owns at least three weapons. And finally, the federal government, both Republicans and Democrats, have agreed that the correct action for gun control is just to deliver thoughts and prayers.
Trent, one final question. What reason would politicians ever have for less gun control?
Yes, it flies in the face of logic and reason. Children have been massacred at alarming rates over the last 20 years, but the best solution politicians can come up with is to arm teachers. And since mental illness is a factor in gun violence, the president wanted to make sure the mentally ill could still buy whatever gun they wanted. As insane as this all sounds, it's great news for investors who continue to make a killing every time guns do.
Trent, thank you. All-round hero, Trent Stone, reporting there. Now, for our final report this evening, appearances can be deceptive. And we can all be guilty of taking things at face value. The art of illusion, creating a false appearance or deceptive impression of reality. Yes, that's how our competitors in the world of fake news made their names. However, our final report has nothing to do with CNN or the BBC. It deals with deception of a different variety. Cab drivers. People who are quick to tell you they are their own boss, but will turn right on command. For a story like this, let's flag down Les Whitlock.
Hello everyone, it's Les Whitlock, and I'm here in the shadow of the Trump Hotel behind me, and also the Capitol. Oh, light pole, let me shimmy over. You can see behind me, it's the Capitol of the United States way back there. And I got a hot coffee with my per diem. So I'm here, and behind me you'll see a cab line. And you know that I've always been very intrigued by the cabs. Well, apparently these cabs are settling for descriptions of their cabs that are not accurate. And I'm gonna dig into this in a few minutes. Just bear with me. So this cab is yellow cab, but clearly it's not yellow, it's red. And then we have this cab here, which I don't know what that means, a seasoned cab. This must offer, perhaps he has seasonings for his fares that he offers them. Again, this is, they all look the same to me. This one is the Swift cab. So this would probably be the fastest of them. This is the premium cab. So of all the cabs, this is probably the best cab. Do you mind if I ask you a few questions?
What?
I'm with CNT News out of Scotland.
Okay.
What's your name?
Kese.
This is Kese.
No, please, don't take picture of me.
So you just talk.
No. Tell me what.
So I'm going to ask you a question. I want to ask you about the cabs, why they have different names. Like this one says Kese. Yeah. This one over here, look. Luxury.
Yeah.
But it's the same as yours.
This is independent.
Ah, so luxury doesn't mean anything, just the name.
Yeah, this is the company.
Ah, this one is premium, and the letters are real big.
Yeah.
But your cab's better.
Yeah, that's my name.
Your name is better than premium.
Yeah.
And this one's luxury.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, my friend.
Okay, yeah. So you are
thank you.
News?
I'm with CNT News. Say hello. Okay, let's turn it around. Hey folks, it's Les Whitlock here, and I'm here with
Kese.
So Kese is one of the drivers here out in front of the Willard Hotel, and he was explaining to me about the names of the cabs. He doesn't have a premium cab, do you?
No.
His cab's not premium, but apparently it is premium.
Yes.
So there you have it. A little bit confusing for the consumer, but not confusing for Kese, right?
Yeah, right.
Okay, this is Les Whitlock from CNT News in Washington, D.C., signing off. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
We have to take it again. Hold on. How's the cab business?
Les, thank you. Les Whitlock, everyone. The only man that receives a tip for being a passenger. And that is about all we have time for this week. A huge thank you to you, the viewer at home. A huge thank you to my sphincter of reporters across the planet. The world is full of opposing views. So why not make 2018 the year less about disagreement and more about debate? Don't have nightmares, and we'll see you next Tuesday.
So there's nothing better than sitting back and relaxing with a nice glass of whiskey from people that make whiskey. Any whiskey's good as long as you drink it in a glass. Sometimes I'll have a double because I have demons. Anyways, that's what Les Whitlock does. What do you do to relax?